What's up, man? This is Ian Beasley, URLTV.TV, Smack URL, the world's most respected MC battle arena. And you are now rocking with Gemski for Gemski TV, man. She's on the go. She's on the move. She's out here getting the content. She's hitting all events. She's getting that coverage in. You know what I mean? So make sure you log on to Gemski's YouTube channel, her website. Follow her on Twitter, on Instagram, because she's on the go. She's making it happen. She's stepping in the trenches with the goons. She's a one-woman show, and she's out here doing her thing. All right, so make sure y'all follow Gemski TV.
Beasley, what's up? It's Gemski TV.
That was coming through. I didn't know you was coming through like that.
Come on. Are you ready for your interview?
We're gonna get it.
Alright.
Waking up to bed, a little rough.
This is how I became involved with URL and battle rap. Like, before URL, there was a DVD called Smack, which many of you know. Smack DVD had battles at the end of every single DVD. It was like the first video magazine. You know, we would go around and get everybody from like Kanye West to Saigon, Corey Guns, 50 Cent, you know, you name it. We had them on there, so it was very popular. And of course, the battle segment was one of the most popular segments on each and every volume that we released. How we linked up. Smack had already done like one or two of them, so around the time when Lux got involved, I knew Corey Guns, you know what I mean? So Corey Guns and Loaded Lux and Rain, who many of y'all seen on here that we worked with, were all like in a group together. So they told me, my man Jim's World, you know, who's a rapper also, said, yo, you gotta check this dude named Poppy out. And that was Lux's other name, Pop Lux. So I checked him out. I told Smack, I was like, yo, we need to bring that dude Murder Mook back against this dude named Lux. And that's how that battle got set up. And that's kind of like how me and Smack started clicking, because around that time I saw what he was doing. But like, I knew a lot of people in the music business because I was already in the industry for a number of years. So like, I was interning at that time, coming up and selling beats and hustling and just doing different shit within the industry. So I had like a lot of like, just relationships and stuff within the mainstream industry, as did Smack. But like, once we started working together, like, our contacts increased, and it kind of took the DVD to another level. We were getting exclusive stories that other people couldn't get. We was getting stories that journalists couldn't get from big magazines and websites. So, you know, that's kind of like what put us out in the forefront of digital media and basically the format for what you see online today with the modern hip-hop blog. It hasn't happened yet.
So far.
Nah, it ain't happened yet. I mean, I'm thankful for everything. You know what I'm saying? I think we've done some great shit, and I think we've been instrumental in bringing battle rap to the mainstream. You know what I mean? I think, like, us taking the chances, getting the big venues, doing the big battles, doing the marquee events, you know, over a thousand capacity events. I think that's what bringing out the celebrities, bringing out the people to host, the energy, the trailers, getting battle rap on major platforms like This Is 50 and Hip Hop DX and Nah Right and, you know, blogs and stuff like that that no one else was doing is kind of what took it over the edge. You know what I'm saying? Of course, the energy that we had coming from the Smack DVD helped bolster and build URL. So, I mean, I'm definitely happy about a lot of things that we were able to achieve. I mean, when we first started, people laughed at us, especially my counterparts, you know what I mean? Because at the same time, when URL started, I was working for Asylum, Atlantic. I was doing A&R there. So, you know, it was kind of winding down, you know, and I'm in the hallways talking about, yo, I'm doing battle rap. I got these battle rappers coming up. That's when you used to see, like, the strategy room. That was like the conference room in Atlantic Records. That was the office. Or like the argument with that's my man's name, K-Shine and Surf. That was like in my office. All that stuff's like in my office when we call in Tech9 and go back and check the blocks, Tech9 and DNA, and they're arguing on the phone and all that strategy. That was all in my office. So I'm bringing these guys to my office. So everyone's looking at me like, yo, you're bugging. What are you involved with these dudes for? They're not signed. They don't have no money. Blah, 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 blah. This is not going to be anything. And they laughed. They're snickering at me. You know what I'm saying? But I kept pressing forward because I knew this was going to be big. You know what I'm saying? I knew that somebody had to try to step in and establish some form of hip hop as we know it. Oh yeah, yeah. I mean, I know what I know. You know what I'm saying? And I believe, you know, without trying to sound cocky or anything, that I'm a visionary. And I know what I believe in, and I know what I felt. It gave me a feeling of something that I lived and experienced. I've always been a part of hip hop. You know what I mean? Even before I was in the industry. I used to sneak into the New Music Seminar back in the day and tape battles as a kid, just to tape MC battles. You know what I mean? So, like, I knew this shit was gonna work because hip hop is boring. There's no aggression. I mean, I don't wanna see nobody get killed or nothing. You know what I'm saying? But I like it when it's rough. I like when people argue. I like when people say shit and have to account for the things that they say. You know what I mean? That's part of hip hop, man. It's not a sensitive love festival that these motherfuckers try to turn this shit into now. That's not what this shit is. It's an aggressive, rough street culture that manifested into a worldwide phenomenon. You know what I mean? And I feel that battle rap has the same potential, or at least is the one element that we can keep, hopefully, and we can, you know, keep that level of competition and hip hop going. So yeah, I did get a lot of naysayers, and it did motivate me. You know, I just hope that we made enough of an impact to make a mark within hip hop, so that, you know, down the line I can say, you know what, I was a part of hip hop culture, and this is the impact that I made personally through my efforts, and that makes me feel good. Challenges I faced have been from venues, trying to get a venue, from MCs, you know, charging, going somewhere and charging somebody $1,000 and then turn around and ask me for $5,000. You know what I'm saying? From guys not wanting to battle other guys, from guys not showing up to battle, and the fans blaming us for somebody's performances, you know. There's numerous things that go into what we do on a daily basis, you know what I mean? Just budgeting and dealing with a bunch of different personalities, you know, trying to find room for certain talent, you know, making a call between you liking someone's skill level or knowing who's going to be the person to sell the door for you to make your money back on your investment. There's so many things that go into it, the preparation. Sometimes people just don't give shit a chance, like, the way you want. So, like, last night I had a dope card, right? I had Real Deal and Rosenberg, Lottize and Born, and Danger Zone and Rome, right? All talented MCs are dope. But because it's not maybe the main names, you know what I'm saying? Or because somebody else does an event that has some big names on it, now all of a sudden, oh, you all know, you guys fell off. You're doing that event. It's not as big as this event. We have our big events. The big events are known. The big events are Summer Madness, Born Legacy around December. Those generally are our biggest of those three marquee events. You know what I mean? But that doesn't mean that I'm going to sit dormant in between events and not do other stuff with this other talented people. I just want people to accept all of it. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you'll get to see the people you want to see. Sometimes you see guys from proven grounds. Sometimes you see guys that are on their way to being the next big thing. And sometimes you will see the biggest guys in the game. Daylyt is funny. He's entertaining. You know what I'm saying? By the way, man, you fucker. Daylyt. I saw what you posted in the room after your Queen of the Ring battle, man. You a funny guy, man. But yo, all in all, like, I'm not mad at Daylyt. Like, you know what I mean? Daylyt is doing what he has to do to make it. You know what I'm saying? He's trying to get some exposure for himself. But, you know, he just has to move with a little more tact and a little more thought, you know what I'm saying, in some of the things that he says and suggests. I think he's a great self-promoter because we're talking about him now. So this is definitely extending his brain and making him more popular. Only time will tell, you know what I'm saying? I can't really say for sure, you know what I mean, what's going to happen with that situation, you know, but like, you know, some of the things that he says, you know what I'm saying? I know he doesn't mean or they're not true, but he has to be careful because everybody that's out there doesn't know that. You know what I'm saying? When you put out videos and you're saying that when you're leaving venues, you're pulling shit down or destroying shit, and you're not, but you say that on the blog, you know, what happens if that venue sees it and decides to sue you all up? Or what happens if that another guy that has a venue sees it and says, I don't want this shit here? You can't bring this here. That's destructive to everybody. It's just tricky with Daylyt. I'll say that. You know what I'm saying? I won't put that on him because I don't want to see him fail. Like, even if he says crazy shit about us sometimes and, you know, that says some funny shit or whatever, like, I take it in stride. Like, I'm not angry with him. It's just figuring out a way to where it won't be a risk, you know what I'm saying, in working with him. So it's not 100% out of the question. Just at this time, I don't have a clear answer on what will happen with Daylyt and URL. Gnome 4 is already done, pretty much. The card is laid out. I'm looking to do Gnome 4 like late May, the first week of June. I'm closing on the venue now. I know people are waiting for a date, but when I release the trailer, I want to have all the pertinent information so that you have ample time to prepare to come out. It's really challenging to find venues. People have to understand that. It's not that we're doing this on purpose to drive you nuts, so we're not working to get it done. Like, all the front ends have been paid for the Gnome card. Everybody got their money already. You know what I'm saying? We got camera crews paid. Everything's done. You know what I'm saying? It's just about securing the venue at this point. That's where the last piece of the puzzle lies, and I'm very close to doing so, you know what I mean? But there's limited venues within the city that will be able to deliver the type of performances with the TV screens and the lighting and the things that you're accustomed to seeing from URL. So we're trying to keep the look consistent. The venue that I have, that I'm closing on for Gnome 4, is a great venue. Everyone's performed in there, from Game to Jay-Z to Juicy J to your favorite rock band, the Joe Buttons. You know, it's going to be a nice look. And it's going to be a dope battle. There's some dope battles on the card. You know what I'm saying? I can't reveal them yet, but trust me, I believe that everybody will be happy. You know, I'm already working on Summer Madness 4 right now. It's finished UFF, which is great, by the way. Season 2, they already want us for Seasons 3 and 4. The jackpots are increasing, so guys have opportunity to win big money. And then there's a lot that I'm doing behind the scenes. Just because I'm quiet doesn't mean that I'm not working. We're doing a 5-year anniversary this October 2 for URL. That's going to be crazy as well. And follow me too, man. My Instagram following is whack compared to Smacks, man. I got like 4,700 people following me on Instagram, man. We need to boost that up. It's Beasley NYC. Beasley NYC on everything, on Twitter and on Instagram. I want to say 2014, I'm coming out, I'm battling. Psych, I lied. I just want to say thanks to everybody, you know, that shows support, whether it be hate, whether it be admiration, frustration, you know what I'm saying? I know some of the hate is motivated by you wanting us to do better. So you say things to get us rolling. But shout out to the people that understand, that respect it. You know, keep in mind it is free entertainment. You know, it is on our YouTube channel, which I would like everybody to subscribe to. It's at the URL TV. Also, log on to our website, urltv.tv. It's everything that encompasses hip-hop. We're expanding the site. We're adding new features. There's a voting feature on there for the battles that we post now that everybody can go on and vote. And we put music videos and everything else. And we're taking a bigger direction. We got a lot of surprises. And I'll tell you this, the reason why I've been quiet is because I've been working on something that's going to be very big for URL and the battle culture. Please, man, take the journey with us. We appreciate all of you. You know, thanks to the people that come to the shows, that tweet, that talk about us, that reach out to us. And, you know, we appreciate all of that shit. We take it all in the stride. It's all love. I'm looking crazy right now, like a burglar. You know, Gemski got me in a room looking nuts. You know what I'm saying? But it's all good. I do it for the people. I do it for y'all. Let's do it. Let's go.